Human Relations. The Journey. The Journey is an excellent piece of work written by Yeshi Georgi Tongchi, a prominent Assamese writer, and it is translated into English by D.P. Nath. The Journey is a beautiful narrative by Yeshi Georgi Tongchi. Most of the events were narrated in the order in which they had happened. The author was a government officer. He came to his village to get married. His parents had arranged his marriage according to their tribal society. After spending 6 months at home, the narrator was going to attend his job after enjoying a long period of leave, but he did not want to leave behind his newly life. He thought of extending his leave too, but when he remembered his increasing responsibilities because of his marriage and debts, he decided to return to work. As there is a hilly terrain without any motorable roads, the author always preferred to carry less luggage. Now his problem was that he needed someone to carry his luggage, as his education has made him avoid physical labor. The author was reluctant to carry his own luggage, as he had the feeling that if he carried the luggage, the whole world would laugh at him. Since most of the villagers were busy in the fields, he couldn't find even one who could help him carry the trunk to the bus stop. Finally, the writer's father was lingering in the narrator's mind that it was improper for him to let his father carry luggage. But he couldn't tell his father about his thought because his guilt and shame did not allow him to do so. He wanted to tell his father that he liked to carry the trunk himself. He knew that he was physically useless in spite of his youth and strength. The writer had to walk fast to catch up his father. He was very tired when he caught up with his father. He sat on a rock to rest for a while. His father drank all the wine given by him and resumed carrying the luggage on his back. The author followed his father. Neither of them spoke a word, as if they were strangers. He concluded that it would be better to let his father carry the luggage and follow him silently. After resting at two places for tiffin, they reached Dirang finally. They entered a tea shop and started sipping tea. His father asked him if he had a pair of old shoes. Then the author looked at his father's bare feet and noticed that they were full of cracks. Theirs was a hilly terrain and the roads were uneven. Never having worn shoes, the narrator's father's feet had developed cracks. He offered his father money, but he refused to take. Instead, he wanted the author's old pair. The author gave him the hunting boots he was wearing. His father was happy with the old shoes his son gave him. His face lit up with contentment when he noticed the author taking out his pair of shoes from the trunk. His father wanted to say something to him, but the bus started moving. Finally, the author realized that both their ways were different. He felt that their journey started in two opposite directions, with him seated in the luxurious seat of a bus and father walking back with tired legs on the pebbles strewn road, while his father was a difficult one. Vocabulary. Compound words. A compound word is union of two or more words to convey a unit idea or special meaning. Hyphenated. Example, newly wed life or return open. Example, bus stop. The above words are called open compounds, hyphenated compounds and closed compounds respectively. Compound words. Duplicate type. The first part of the word is repeated without any change. Example, bye-bye. Alternative type. The two parts have the same consonant but different vowels. Example, dilly-dally. Rhyming type. The second word starts with a different consonant but rhymes with the first part. Example, super duper. Another woman. The poem is about the domestic violence happening against women all over India. Another woman suggests that one more woman has lost her life. It is not limited to a single woman. The poem starts with a picture of the woman who is in the market for purchasing vegetables. She buys methi for the daily purpose of the kitchen. She wishes for a radish, but thinking if it is an extravagance. She leaves her wish. She returns to it. For all women in the poem who does not have freedom to spend money, it is an extravagance. She counts the coins carefully and ties them in a small bundle into her sari at the waist. This shows her poverty. At home, she has to face the harsh behavior of her mother-in-law. She handles the methi with care and chops them and other vegetables with care and makes curry. At the time of this, she tries to protect herself from the heat. The mother-in-law cursed her spending the money and also utters cursing words against her parents for sending this girl to their house to spoil their fortunes. The girl listened to all by sitting bent in front of the kerosene stove. She does not face her husband, who comes by listening to this and keeps quiet. The girl did not look into the face and nor raised her heads. She does not have faith and confidence in her husband. She did not believe that he could not come to her rescue. Her husband did not have any love for her. Though he listened to the harsh speech of his mother, he did not show any concern for his wife. Listening to her mother-in-law's cursing her and her parents is a common thing to her. She is ready to bear all her sufferings silently. From the childhood onwards, she had been getting lessons how to behave in law's house. So, the only option left in front of her to take her life. She never made a complaint against her mother-in-law. She was not giving any right to speak. She was loyal to her husband. She was very humble till then. She obeyed him and did not make any complaints against him or his mother. She could not bear her sufferings anymore. Hence, she committed suicide, finally to get rid of domestic violence. The woman herself threw the kerosene and submits her into the hands of the flames. It is only her end. There are other girls. She is only a representative. There are women in our society who are struggling much like this, who are escaping like this. But the society pays no attention to this and turns face in order to escape from blames. Glossary. Methi. Fenugreek. white radish, white and round or finger-shaped vegetable. Extravagance, spending more than necessary in an uncontrolled way. The never, never nest. The never, never nest is a one comic net play about a young couple who brought everything on installment basis. The play is a satire on the materialistic bent of the modern man. Jack and Jill were a young married couple who had a small baby. One day, Aunt Jane, who is young couple's aunt, visited them. She was surprised to find that even though Jack's salary was not high, they lived in a beautiful home with all comforts, such as radio, car, refrigerator, etc. She began to wonder, how did Jill buy all these things? Owing the things such as the furniture, house, car, piano, etc. at a young age is not easy thing to do. Aunt Jane was shocked to know the things of the young couple did not belong to them. They got all the things on installment basis. Buying things on installment basis liked by Aunt Jane. Jane was earning £6 a week. Jill was a housewife. When Aunt Jane asked how he could pay a £7 a week when he was only £6, Jack said that they could take a loan. Aunt Jane was shocked at the way Jack and Jill run their family. Before she left, she gave £10 to Jill and told them to make one article completely theirs. Using that money, Jill thanked Aunt Jane for the present. Glossary. Villa, small house standing in its own garden. Cozy, warm and comfortable. Shriek, a high loud cry. Exclaim, speak with strong feelings. Thingamy, a word used in spoken English when the name of an object has been forgotten. Tartar, an irritable, hard to cope with person. Few, expression of tiredness, shock or relief.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.